digging wells, or building schools, or hospitals, or roads. Many people are doing that. We applaud it. We want others to be involved. But our primary concern is to be a Christian, evangelical response to the MDGs. And we were mandated by two significant global movements, Micah Network and the World Evangelical Alliance, somewhere around the year 2002. I had the privilege of working to bring these two organizations together to begin to think through how we might respond to these promises. And this was formally launched, Micah Challenge was formally launched on the 15th of October in the year 2004. Now, you really should write that down in my unfinished work there. It was kind of crazy, but it was launched in 2005 by Micah Network and the World Evangelical Alliance, what you should say. And you really should write down the 15th of October. That was the date we were launched at the United Nations. And it's a very, very important date because it also happens to be my birthday. Gifts, presents, and cards. What was fascinating for us in that launch as we stood together in the United Nations was that we recognized this really was a momentous time for the whole world in relation to King Poverty, but also Christians in our response to these promises. Because we could have responded in a number of ways, couldn't we? We could have said, well, actually, this is all too big and too complicated, and anyway, we're involved in a lot of social action already. Why should we get involved any further? We may want to discuss it in a little while when we have a chance to respond. Or we could have said, this has been launched under the auspices of the United Nations. And we all know that that is Babylon come down. Must be slightly demonic, so we shan't go there. But to actually stand as a Pentecostal United Nations to be a part of a Christian enterprise to say, no, we think these promises resonate with the spirit of the Old Testament prophets, with the ministry of Jesus, and with the work of the church for 2,000 years, and we therefore want to make a prophetic response to this, was a very humbling and also a very challenging moment for us as we launched Micah Challenge. Since then, we have been working with 40 national campaigns in different parts of the world. 28 of these are in the global south, Asia, Africa, Latin America, the rest stretched across places like Australia, New Zealand, and the global north. And our responsibility is to approach this with a prophetic posture, or from a prophetic posture. Ladies and gentlemen, we are involved in this not because we are playing politics, not because we are political specialists or economic analysts. We're involved in this because the scriptures mandate us to take this issue seriously. The reason we're called Micah Challenge and the Micah Network is drawn from the book of Micah, chapter 6, verse 8. He has shown you, O man, O woman, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? But to act justly, to love mercy, to walk humbly with your God. When we lobby our politicians, either in Africa or Asia or America or Canada or Switzerland or the UK, we don't come at them with baseball bats to beat them up. We come as critical.